alive, and it's just the best hero, I think, yeah. coupled with him.
It just complements him well, because Terrorblade's great at single target and doing huge amounts of damage, not so great when people can just man up and kind of run at him. But when you have a Tide who can mitigate damage coming towards you and just drop that huge AoE disable, usually Terrorblade, or at least picked up a kill or two from the duration of that that Ravage. So I agree with you. I think Tide would fit very nicely into this Empire draft. We've seen a lot of just the Tide, Iron Talon. Forget about the offlane. I'm going straight into the jungle so I can get my XP on.
Yeah. And something I really want to touch on that we didn't get the chance to yet is that Arteezy's had a really good time in this tournament on Timbersaw, as well as the Elder Titan on Puppy or for Puppy. Mm-hmm. So it seems like when those two are banned, it takes Secret a little bit out of their comfort zone, and they haven't been doing as well the second day when they take out the ET. So that is something to note.
Shadow Demon, fourth ban here from Empire. All right. Good setup with Axe. And it is one of the better heroes to deal with Terrorblade because of the Soul Catcher. Mm-hmm. I don't think you're normally picking a Shadow Demon into a Terrorblade, and we've got the hard counter boys, but towards that late game when he's a big beefcake, that is one of relatively few tools that work really well against him. Of course, Elder Titan is right now kind of the cream of the crop in terms of Terrorblade counters. Late game, the Earth Splitter does huge percentage damage to his big HP pool, and early game, well, of course, Natural Order cuts through all of that tanky armor. So
I think the best support hero for Team Secret is either that Shadow Demon or Lion now. Lion, you could just get rid of two images, set up really nicely.
Try to burst him down with Sunder, all that kind of stuff. Yeah, Lion's really incredible.
So the question is now, do Team Empire want to pick Lion themselves?
If they took Lion here, what's next on the list for Secret?
Disruptor.
Disruptor. Maybe Dazzle. There's the Earth Spirit here for Empire. Okay.
I think Team Secret. Nah, they couldn't have probably gone away with the Earth Spirit. Okay. Dragonite for Arteezy. Mr. Artor. Could still be Eternal Envy, but normally only E's been playing the DP.
I think that's definitely an Arteezy hero. I feel like DK does not fit Envy's style.
No.
They've been playing a lot of Weaver on Envy recently. I wonder if they want to pick that here.
Against Terrorblade, I don't think so.
Yeah.
It's one of those heroes that it does get Lincolns to help for that Sunder play, but don't know if it's gonna. It could be very good if they just run over them. That's the best part about Weaver. You're just constantly running at Terrorblade, and when he has that Metamorphosis down, it's pretty useless.
Yeah. All right, Empire. Time to see how this draft is gonna unfold. They've got their two supports. They need their mid as well as their off lane. What matches up really well against the DK? Razor. Okay, there you go.
No, Razor. Still really surprised they didn't pick the Tidehunter, as we were talking about. They're just going to leave it for last to see what they really need.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe they just don't want to have a huge ultimate, a long cooldown to work with, but I think most teams have had the most success with TB and Tide. Team Secret now on their side, I think they should go for a support hero here, just to leave everything wide open.
Yeah, they won't have final pick in this game. They were able to first pick the Darkseer. When we're talking about supports, I think Lion is still kind of the quote-unquote obvious choice here in terms of conventional heroes to deal with the Terrorblade.
Nothing else is really sticking out that's just as good. And besides maybe the Disruptor, but they'll save it for last. And Slark, it's decent good. It's a decent hero.
This is an interesting Secret draft. Very melee intensive. That's the thing that jumps out at me. You got four melee heroes. Magnetize good against that. Razor, okay. I mean, he does AoE damage, so having melee heroes kind of clumped up, but it seems like Empire don't really have too much to punish this heavy melee lineup.
No, and they don't have the way to burst down heroes really effectively, so they're just kind of like that sieging team or that defensive team right now for Team Empire. It's just like, what do we actually do? Whereas Team Secret, they have a lot of ways to initiate, in this game. That's why their lineup looks super scary. But if Team Empire can hit this window like we talked about and they're just taking all the tier 1s and tier 2s, it could be problematic for Secret.
I think that's where Razor's really scary. Like, it's a hero that we haven't seen played too much, but he still fits into that. Like, we want to be super aggressive in that early timing window, and he can scale pretty well. I mean, he's a good anti-carry, and he's really good at sieging once he gets the ags.
So, with Disruptor being banned, I should have said that earlier. Herp derp. I mean, there's really only.
Oh, yeah, look at that. First ban.
Yeah. All right, so what else? What other off the wall can we do? Get that Coddle.
I mean, Coddle. Dazzle is still in there. Coddle is definitely a hero that Secret Run, though. Usually,
but,
Puppy's the one that plays it, and he's
the Pilot
that
would have to be Axe.
I mean, it's not a good Rubick game.
It's okay. You pick Rubick, and then you anticipate the Tide pick.
I mean,
that's next level.
That is a possibility. You take the Rubick to dissuade the Tide, if that's something they're afraid of. That could be something. I mean, it's a pretty good setup for Axe, Slark. Could
that
fit.
That no field, though, for that Air Spirit ulti.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it helps. It helps.
It does a bit.
Razor's ult is physical. Helps against Plasma Field, but it's pretty minor. Not an obvious Rubick game by any stretch, but it is something that Pylite Dai can play, of course. If it's not Dazzle, remaining. Lion, or Rubick, then I'm not sure.
Winter Wyvern.
All right, so some good lockdown here.
Good heals, more heals on the team.
Actually, the Cold Embrace is incredible here. They don't have much magic damage, like skill shots. You know, against a Shadow Fiend, you kind of go, okay, might save him sometimes, might kill him other times. This is, what do they do against Cold Embrace? Run
and
away.
The turnaround play with Winter's Curse on one hero, Terrorblade is just going to annihilate one of his allies.
Yeah, can't believe it. We forgot about Winter Wyvern, man. That is a really good pick here.
Like, this Winter Wyvern plus Axe combo was first introduced on this patch, like, a month or two ago when it was not today.
Oh, yeah.
And,
you can set it up with the ult, and then Axe just gets in position and calls the whole team.
Ooh.
And an Earthshaker for Empire. All right, well, we just saw the Earthshaker played by Escape Gaming. It was very successful in the hands of Yapzor. For Empire, this is looking to be a bit different, though, because it's a Core Shaker.
Yeah.
Or is it a Core Venge?
It's
a Core Shaker.
Get that Jungle Terrorblade, Gappa.
Huh. Peculiar from Empire.
Yeah.
Did not expect an Earthshaker final pick at all.
No, but it
does punish the heavy melee heroes. That was one thing that we were talking about.
Yeah.
I mean, Echo Slam, incredible when you're all grouped up like that.
And you need some magical burst damage to deal with, as we talked about, the Cold Embrace. It also helps burst the vacuum wall.
Mm-hmm.
Clear out all those.
I don't think Earthshaker is bad here. It just is
hard
to
execute.
I don't think
it's good, but
with.
It's very, yes, very hard for Team Empire to execute this lineup to perfection. It's like Razor kind of sticks out as the sore thumbs in this lineup, and then you have the Earthshaker having to basically carry this game. So, Secret's draft is a little bit favored. We'll have to see if Empire can give us a really good game.
I think Secret's draft is much more in their comfort zone as well. These are heroes that, no reason why they shouldn't feel pretty comfortable here. The Puppy Axe, he gets a pick that he wants for himself. I don't really feel like doing predictions right now. This game's too important for these fantasy predictions that don't matter.
Oh, man.
Look at these
words. What a sellout.
All right, fine. Wait, this is going to be a first one. Mapochka's in kind of an awkward spot here. All right, Puppy trying to intercept him, but not quite able to do it. A little bit of a close call.
Well, the sad part is they got vision of him, and he still has two wards on him. So the only thing he could have placed was maybe a sentry ward, but he didn't place anything.
Okay. Player with the least deaths?
Yeah, I had to think about that for a long time, and I still don't know yet.
I think I'm just going to pick Puppy. I don't think it's right, but I'm going for it. Highest net worth at 10 minutes.
That's
Terrorblade. The most Roshan kills. What? Well, first Roshan and most Roshan. Right, I'm going to go crazy here. I think Empire is going to kill it first, and I think Secret is going
to
kill it
more
times. Yeah,
I was actually about to put that, but then I was just like, whatever, just give it to Empire still.
That's a weird... some of these predictions are kind of weird. It's like, I don't know. It doesn't... I feel like I'm just guessing.
Let me just roll the dice here.
Yeah. Let me page Nahaz, get the statistics on Roche percentages.
I mean, come on, guys. His Manila major predictions, Kappa, do you see that? Like,
no,
one out of every thing he got might maybe right. So bad. Don't listen to that guy.
Poor
also, also Merlini too. Wings Gaming.
Oh, I saw that thread actually. Yeah, the predictions. Oh God.
That was funny.
You
I
all
lost
the shots
too,
you don't take.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't even think I did predictions, so I can't flame. Radiant Wards, they'll get Vision of the top rune, as well as that bottom lane. Dire still holding on to theirs, at least for now, it looks like. If they're on the map, I don't see them. Poshka's got one, he's got two. So they're going to be a little more defensive with their wards. It's kind of interesting to see that. So many teams now, it feels like, are prioritizing that early movement, like TPing to a lane, smoking out so they can get the wards down before it's scouted. Empire are kind of taking the opposite approach here, where they're saving the wards until they know where they need to be.
Just saving for that first nighttime, have four wards up.
Yeah, that's a strategy, I guess.
The strat.
The strat. Alright, a little action up here in the top lane. Puppy taking decent damage. Bulba's already given him the Ion Shell, so not the easiest hero to man up on. But they are at least being a nuisance. Terrorblade still last hitting pretty well under the tower, number one CS. And down bottom, Arteezy gonna be happy on the Slark. Pylai die nearby, just doing a little stacking, a little pulling. Pretty standard support stuff here in the Radiant Jungle.
Yeah, and that nice fissure block from Afterlife. I need to pay attention to what he just did. Oh well.
Do you have faith in the offlane Shaker here? We talked about it last game, and of course it was on the position 4. And in the 3, it's great if you can actually get space in the lane. But the problem with Earthshaker is the recovery. He can't really Iron Talon jungle too effectively. And he's got one last hit already, almost level 2. He hasn't been aggressively zoned out, but now the Arctic Burn comes. There's going to be a battle for this bottom rune. Not sure if Pylai Dai is going to be able to get it, though. It's a nice haste there for Afterlife. Easy peasy.
Unfortunately, he didn't go and contest this pool here. He would have gotten level 2 100%, but... have Maposhka kind of rotating around here. Mm-hmm. And that just is going to leave, you know, this Venge and Ramzy's up here all alone. So this is...
dude, this mid lane is a womp. Scandal's 14-7 compared to the 4-0.
Hey, you said Arteezy wasn't going to play...
oh, and it's Envy playing the DK.
Yeah,
you're
man.
Right. I just noticed. Oh, my.
Yeah, we're putting you on the bench.
Yeah. I'm surprised. I mean, do you disagree, though? Like, I really don't think Dragon Knight is, like, a quote-unquote Envy hero, just the way he likes to play. Like, Weaver strikes me as an Envy hero. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but I think... I honestly think Arteezy's better at Slark, though. So I get what you mean.
It's a kind of a toss-up. So what do you do here if you're a Dragon Knight in this scenario where you're getting completely boxed out? Razor has twice as many denies as Dragon Knight has last hits. How do you recover from this?
You just gotta get level 6 and just start pressuring towers. Just okay. bottle control. Either you get the runes or you just keep, you know, faring out.
I see. So bottle spam, use that breathe fire, and then utilize your pushing prowess. I like that. That's definitely a golden ticket back into the game.
Problem
I just didn't
is
expect this to be
like,
so one-sided.
Yeah, it's so one-sided because he went Quelling Blade for no reason. Like, normally in the standard, you know, matchups, you want to, but in this lane, you actually can only CS with bottle.
I see. Yep, and it was a pretty obvious Razor mid as well, nothing else that would really go here. Envy will get manned up on a little bit. Dragon's Blood gives him some decent armor, so at least the right clicks from Scandal don't hurt too much. Pretty hard for them to secure a kill, but even just boxing out the farm on the Dragon Knight is a sure victory for Empire. Now, for Razor, what do you think in item build-wise for Scandal? I mean, is he like a mech carrier here? You just get a nice early mech, kind of play it like you would a Viper, and then just kind of start the Death Ball and prepare to defend towers against the Sieging Dragon Knight, or... do you go Midas? Do you invest in something different? What are you thinking?
It's a good question. The way that Fada plays it is Saint and Yasha still.
Like phase boots, SNY, just straight up.
Treads.
Oh, Treads.
You know,
okay.
Treads, Aquila, Magic Wand, maybe Raindrops in this game, and...
right into the SNY. That could be good.
Yeah. But in this game, they might prioritize the mech, as you're saying. They might want to team fight more. So it's basically up to him. Probably between those two items.
All right. And checking in on the offlane, not really going so well for Secret either. Axe with 12 last hits, Darkseer with 9. They're kind of sharing the farm, splitting everything. It's not really going poorly, but they're not really stopping this Terrorblade from farming. All things considered, Ramzy is fairly comfortable up here under his tower.
Yeah, and that's very weird for me. I thought they would be able to put more pressure with this dual lane,
yeah,
considering Maposhka rotated off the lane. There for a little, like, 2 minutes.
Maposhka is only level 1.
Puppy, though, and he's dead.
Yeah, there's the boulder up top. He does get off the Berserker's
Call. Nice Bulba.
Yeah, they're going to actually get a counter kill on Mapochka. Pylai Dai rotates up, and it's Bulber getting the first blood. Very nice turnaround. Ramsey's now on the run.
Oh my god, how is ES level 1 at 5.5 minutes in the game? That is why that... I was like, there's no way he gets out because there's a stun, right?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, what? Level 1?
It's like, wait, hello? Yeah, I don't know. He spent so much time parking this mid lane. Like, DK was already getting zoned out, and he was just kind of hiding in the trees here, like, looking for an opportunity to gank, and it never really came. He rolled in a couple times, and I don't know, I guess Earth Spirit generally is going to pick on the mid hero, and you're up against a Dragon Knight. That is not someone you can reliably kill.
Yeah, very, very unfortunate there. It would have been still very close. I think they would have gotten it. But as you said, let's look back in mid lane. So Eternal Fish is just getting crushed. I actually just want to look at the net worth right now. 2,800 to that of 1,500. That is
for
like,
6 minutes. That is
like,
insane.
It's like doubled almost.
Yeah, Puppy, Invisibility Rune, Ion Shell soon to expire, rotating in towards the mid. And King R going to pull a rotation of his own. Arteezy pretty quiet in the bottom lane, just farming away on his Slark. Looks like Power Tread's coming out. Aquila before too long. Really nothing too crazy happening down there.
So, let's see. Arteezy is doing good for himself here. I'm wondering if he'll get involved early. He might want to rotate top lane, put pressure. It seems like they want to take this tower here shortly for secret.
Yeah, starting to group up in this top lane tower, down to about 2/3 HP. Should be a fairly easy siege. 7 minutes, only one kill. It's been a quiet game as Terrorblade now moves into the jungle. And we'll see a smoke rotation mid. Earthshaker starts it up onto Envy. They kick him back, but he's still pretty darn tanky. Level 6 on the DK. Could turn into a breathe fire, but it's just not going to matter. It's soon going to be a 1-on-5 scenario. He'll just make a little bit of space, and we'll end up falling to the wrath of the Razor.
That's just painful.
Dyer's yeah. Top tower is under attack. Poor guy.
And
1-to-1.
Yeah, it's still though. It's kind of like an Envy kill, but now you're actually getting pressure on the top tower. Oh.
So what are you thinking about this Earthshaker? Like, has he gotten enough out of the lane for this pick to be warranted? He's level 5, 7 last hits. I think it's gone fairly well for Afterlife.
Yep, he's got his Tranquils. He can start spamming spells. Things considered, it's pretty good.
Maybe it was a good read. They were thinking, well, they're going to go 2-1-2. Puppy and Bulba will be in the off lane, so that means we can get away with this greedier off lane pick because he's not going to be hard zoned out by two supports. Could have been a good read. Here we go. Puppy goes in, misses the Berserker's call, but Secret have the superior numbers. Scandal rotating in from the back line, but Ramsey's gets decapitated. No Sunder for him. Arteezy losing some damage, but he will get, tries to break it, and now has to head back. Minus 70 on the Slark. That's not ideal. They'll get the quick pick on the Terrorblade and just retreat. Happy to see Empire rotating so many forces and not finding a kill of their own.
You know, I was literally clicking on this Terrorblade. Like, he just got level 7. I was like, okay, are you going to play super greedy and get that extra and conjure image? And guess what? Yes, he did. Didn't want that Sunder.
Yep.
And that's going to cost them.
Almost a deny there from the Earth Spirit. But that whole time, Envy was just split pushing down bottom. So you were exactly right. You get wrecked in the lane. Well, you can always knock down towers. So capitalizing on the rotation from Empire. And pushing a nice, easy tier 1 in the safe lane.
That's what you like to see from Envy.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just can't take that mid. And I'm pretty sure the tower in the bottom lane was like at half HP, and then just finishing it off helps.
Mm-hmm. It helps get him back on track. I mean, Razor's still really far ahead, but buff up that team gold and at least get you on that road to recovery. He's now level 7, and Arteezy has a lot of space to farm in the bottom lane. Up top, nice deny from Vengeful Spirit. Bulba bested in the battle for the last hit. Fissure connects on 2, and Afterlife will just retreat. Yeah, these teams are playing like there is so much on the line here because, well, there is. 2-1, only 10 minutes in. The battle of positioning.
I'm just watching Eternal Envy try to get CS mid. That's basically what it's come down to now. Like, can he farm?
Throw the Quelling Blade at him. Come on.
The battle. No, Scandal's just kind of a monster here. So
he's still doubling his last hits. 25 to 52.
I'm just worried about my prediction. 57. We wrong. Arteezy. Gonna get that player with the highest net worth at that 10 minutes. Oh, Scandal, boy.
Oh, he's dead. Oh, beautiful fissure. Arteezy jumps over it. Scandal's throwing a lot of damage here. Artor needs to be a little bit careful, but now the Arctic Burn comes in. They should have the damage to bring him down. They do, just barely. Arteezy stunned up. Cold Embrace is there to pick him right back up. Now this fight continues with Secret on the aggressive. Going to be a nice fissure to help break things up. Envy getting kind of low, but he will stand his ground. Pops the wand. Breathe fire onto King R. Gets stunned. And now Ramses joins the party from the high ground. Splinter Blast from Pylai Dai secures the kill on Venge. 2-0. Secret with a lot of low HP heroes will get out of dodge. Puppy could be a casualty here. Another nice fissure. But they just can't get the follow-up to secure these kills.
Man, I'm just watching this Terrorbelly walk around like 700 HP. It's like a little paper. It's like paper floating around the map.
Yeah.
It's just so fragile. And they just used their Metamorphosis and they're not even going to get anything out of it. So that's a huge win for Secret right now.
Yeah, I like how Envy positioned in that fight. You know, he's pretty far behind, but it hasn't gotten to him. He positioned himself knowing that he's tanky, he can stay in the front line, and even at 20% HP, he's not an easy hero to bring down. And just that kind of posturing helped Secret do that song and dance where they were able to move heroes in and out, and, you know, they found two kills. They took a lot of damage, but they were able to spread that damage so it, you know, didn't yield any deaths on their side. Very nice. It's a 3k net worth lead for them now, too.
That team fight could look completely different if they had Mapochka, his level 6, but that's just how Dota works, you know? You take advantage of these lower level supports and rotating around. So, this is... And the problem with Empire now, when you fall behind like this in the early game, you're just like, what the hell do we do besides farm? And then if you're farming, that's just like saying, okay, Secret, right, here you go. Here's your blink on Axe. Here you go. Come blink, call me. Come kill me while I'm just farming.
You're totally right. You look at this Empire lineup, and you draft heroes like this because you want to dominate lanes and you want to take an early lead, right? You want to carry that momentum towards the mid game. And yeah, they're definitely not doing that here. Their Terrorblade as well as Razor are still farming reasonably well, but they have lost a lot of that momentum, and Arteezy already has a Shadow Blade to go with his power charge. He's just been sitting all by his lonesome down bottom. He's picked up a couple of assists now, and nearly 100 last hits. This is a great timing on the Shadow Blade.
Yeah, he's rotated to every single team fight too.
Has he really?
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like it, but you're right, he has. Yeah, he actually has. I'm selling it short, that's my bad. Well done, Arteezy, doing a great job min-maxing, farming, as well as fighting.
Yeah, he kind of has to come to the team fights after they don't have enough DPS.
Yeah.
To really burst down the Terrorblade. Oh, I thought it broke the Slark, but no, he's still fishing.
Yeah, Ion Shell. That extra little bit of added damage, man. The Darkseer is so annoying with these stealthy assassin type heroes. Mm-hmm. Rotation towards the mid. They'll get a nice aggressive ward down. Kind of cut this lane in half so they can see what rotations are coming in. You see pings coming from Axe. They know Afterlife is there. Arteezy not going to be able to find the opening. They do have a sentry ward down. He needs to be a little bit careful. Look at this aggression from Secret, though.
Scandal's like, I need to go up, guys, but I can't. Oh, he's going up.
Arteezy pounces away. He's going to lose some damage here, but that's all right. Silence now by Mapochka. Oh, my beautiful winner's curse. That keeps Arteezy alive. Puppy dies on the back line. They're going to lose the Darkseer also. The Winner's Curse, not enough.
And the X.
Yep.
At the same time.
2-0. Hyper aggression there from Secret a little bit. They didn't really have to take that fight between the towers. Couldn't they have just used the Elder Dragon form, siege the tower, and then kind of look for a pickoff that way?
Yeah, Arteezy kind of baited his team into a really bad position there. And then they just split up, and then Empire just completely punished them. They had to use the Wyvern ulti very defensively, and Terrorblade wasn't caught out, so he didn't kill anybody, and they're just like, whoops, Arteezy.
Yeah, 4-3, that lead Secret has, starting to trickle back down. Empire showing a sign of life. They're still in this game. How is the Blink Dagger progress here, Afterlife? Going for a different build, not going for the Arcane Boot Shaker, just Tranquils with the Soul Ring and a Wand. Still pretty far away from the Blink, with only about 300 in savings. Envy double damage. I get stunned up and just walks away. Nice power deny here from King R on that tier 1 mid.
That's still the good thing coming out from CK. Even though they lost two heroes, they've still gotten all the map control right now. Up three towers.
Yeah, I mean, just look at how they're positioned. They've got two heroes in the enemy jungle. It's kind of hanging out, clearing out neutrals like it ain't no thing.
They just don't have enough lockdown to really kill anybody without having their Shaker to have a blink. And the Venge swap, it's primarily for defensive purposes so far in this game.
Yeah, so far at least. 0, 1, and 1. Kingar, struggling to find opportunities to use it. Terrorblade is number 1 in net worth, though. Ramses has himself the Dragon Lance to go with his Power Treads. And they're going to get a tower in the bottom lane. It looks like there's a glyph for Secret. They'll use it. But this tower is going to fall before they can really react. Meanwhile, in the top lane, Dragon Knight knocks down that tower. Envy doing a great job split pushing. Puppy goes in for initiation onto Afterlife. There is some follow up on both sides. Magnetize connects on Puppy, spreads to another. Boulder and Maposhka. Oh, Arteezy actually misses the pounce. That would have been almost a guaranteed kill. Very nicely done by Maposhka.
Can't believe he juked that.
Yeah. Oh, not juking this one. Trying to TP out. Berserker's Call catches him. That's a slam dunk for Puppy on the Axe. 5-3, Secret. Regain a little bit of that footing. All the while in the top lane, hey, it's Eternal Envy. He did half damage to Tier 3 tower.
Jeez.
At 15 minutes, that's pretty damn good. And he forced Scandal back, so set it up for the rest of his team to be more aggressive.
Yeah, and they got the Tier 2 before that.
Yeah.
So that is a huge win coming out for the side of...
Yeah,
Secret.
Even though these trades have been pretty even, you're right, the map control for Secret is really... I mean, even just look at this ward right here. They know exactly what's going on, who's farming what. They are ready to move into enemy territory and fight if they get a good opportunity.
And they're just not getting any map control for Empire. That's my biggest worry right now. And with all this extra gold coming in from the towers, I mean, look at Bulba now. He's finally
got... Cool. Look at Puppy! Full man mode. Afterlife says, okay, slam dunk, I'll take that, thank you.
Oh, is he gonna
God, dude. That is the dream.
Okay, Puppy's like, you fucking idiot.
Wow. And Arteezy is on
He's
the
getting
high
pinged by Puppy, so mad.
And he doesn't have enough mana to use his TP
scroll. Arteezy.
And he doesn't have enough mana to pounce, because they cost close to the same. Oh boy.
That's
Arthur.
The walk of shame.
Yeah, that's
and
that's
the TP
tough.
Of shame.
No, for the Earthshaker, though, that is so completely worth it, just getting a solo kill. He's now 1,200 gold towards the Blink Dagger.
Yep.
He'll take that trade at this stage of the game literally anytime, even if it's not a deny to Roche. Like, he'll happily trade his life for a 1-to-1 kill like that.
And that's not even like a support axe. It's like a 4-position really farmed axe, too.
Yeah.
So he's just really happy with that kill because he gets a lot of bubbles and he gets that... You know, the extra gold there.
Yeah, making a nice little mountain set here. Secret all over the place as they take the lead and then get hyper aggressive and kind of throw it away. All the while, Ramsey's continuing to farm up, moving towards his Manta style. That's a Yasha in tow. And Scandal, he's picked up a Dragon Lance of his own. All right, not an item we were thinking about with the Razor, but there is some pretty obvious synergy there. I do like it. Envy now initiated on mid. Uh-oh, Magnetize used, stunned up by the Venge. Are they going to have the damage to bring him down? Mech. Picks him up, but the swap back, Bulba, into a winner's curse. They keep Envy alive. No counter kill, but good defensive team play from Secret. Envy lives.
Just good team effort there from Secret, and only having three heroes, you just see. Like, with these picks, you have no burst damage. Mm-hmm. It's like all over time, and that's the problem when you don't have the Terrorblade in the team fights.
Yeah. Arteezy was thinking about moving into enemy jungle. Thought twice, though, thinking there could be some sentry baits about. Does have his Echo Saber up, though. Well, pretty standard stuff for Slark, but coming online. Behind the Terror Blade, but not by too much.
Alright, guys. So, right now, is there anybody that's really benefiting right now? Nope. It's pretty much dead even. But this could be a very big team fight.
Yep. Smoke now from Secret, Empire, very defensive positioning. All their heroes turtled up in the base, respecting Secret being off the map, realizing that some sort of an aggressive play is inbound.
Yeah, there's nobody on the map right now. Pretty obvious smoke gink.
Yeah. And DK, he's going to pick up a Dragon Lance also. It's just a double stack of Ancients, it looks like. Every little bit helps. Slark. Still scouting on the high ground here.
And they didn't kill big ancients too. And we like that lag though.
Yeah, a little lag spike.
The lag though. Pylite die. Thank you for the free ward.
Yeah, Maposhka on the high ground here. We'll take a look at Vision. This is Radiant Vision we've got here. You can see Empire posturing on the high ground. And this is Empire Vision. They see little inklings of the Dragon Knight. And they see the movement back from Bulba. And they'll feel pretty safe. No one moving into Roche quite yet. We'll stay standing.
It's... Oh, nope, didn't stack. Fail.
That's unfortunate.
Well, get the extra ward down here.
And he's got a haste rune in the bottle. Are they going on Afterlife? They sure are. Arteezy runs in as they set up with a stun. Nice pick on the Earthshaker. The rest of Empire grouped up over the corpse of their Earthshaker. They shed a tear and go right back to farming. BKB on the way for the Razor. Arteezy still just so aggressive with his positioning, clearing out the enemy jungle constantly. Empire, I feel like they've spent way too much time locked in their base as five heroes, given that they still have all these tier 2 towers standing.
Yeah, I don't know how Empire still don't have more map control in this game, but at least they have gotten 2 towers. Mm-hmm. I'm not even sure how they got those, because I guess it's just from the Terrorblade constantly constantly pushing, and they made that heavy commitment for those Ancients, but it was only like 2 of them. So
yeah,
that was a little bit of a misplay maybe from Secret, but they're still going to get this mid tower.
Yeah, it's going down no matter what. Glyph's already been used. Envy, a little bit of time left on this Elder Dragon form, gets initiated on by Maposhka, but another great winner's curse onto Scandal. Arteezy in the fray. There's the setup from Puppy right into the back wall. Secret finally getting their wombo combo. They get 2, and now King R are going to be in a lot of trouble. Darkseer will fall thanks to the dunk of Afterlife. It does soften him up. It's a 1-for-2. Not quite as good for Secret as it first seemed, but they still bring down the tower, denied by Terrorblade, and do find a successful fight.
Yeah, and if Afterlife had a blink there, oh my goodness, that would have been disastrous for Secret.
He's almost got it now.
He'll have it soon, but that was a really nice combo play coming in from Secret. So their team fight, it's getting there. It's not the perfect play, but
we saw the potential there. And it doesn't have to be in that order. That's the thing about it. It could be a vacuum into a Winner's Curse. It could be a Winner's Curse into a Berserker's Call.
Yep.
Any kind of mixture of the three is really potent. And if you can get all 3 of them off, it's devastating.
That Fissure block, though, it helped a lot for disengaging. Like, it's really annoying probably for Arteezy. He's probably saying, this Fissure in this game, boys. I'm like, I can't leap over it. It's too hard.
What does Arteezy get next item here? He's got 2,500 gold, 2,600 Shadowblade, Echo Saber. What's next?
Let's see, in this game...
Not really a Shadow or a Silver Edge kind of game.
No, Silver Edge, not really.
Unstable current, not so threatening.
I'm thinking if he wants to go for Scotty in this game, or if he wants to go for Butterfly. Probably just wants to get more stats. 1500 HP isn't the best.
Yeah.
BKB is sometimes a necessity, especially when you go against that Earthshaker, since he can permastun you.
Yeah.
At times from
afar.
A lot
of stuff that goes through the BKB, but ultimately you have to be able to pop that magic immunity and focus on whatever target it is you're trying to train. So
yeah.
I think it's pretty likely he'll pick one up sooner rather than later. It's a good call.
It's either BKB or Scotty for sure.
Yeah. Although, you know, Silver Edge, we talk about Terrorblade, as the game goes on, it's not just about removing passives. It also does prevent damage done based on a percentage. So it is an item that can kind of scale into the late game. And if you're running like a lineup that ends up being a little more single core oriented, can really neuter the amount of damage output that Terrorblade can do. But at the same time, he has a lot of illusions. So maybe not the best counter on that front.
Too many Timber Souls
in
your dreams, man.
We are
fantasies.
Almost at the 12-hour mark here for casting. It's definitely getting a little loopy. Tummy's rumbling for that breakfast.
I'm loopy. Man, that... I forgot what that's from, actually. Is that Family Guy? That's been a long time. Oh, well.
Yeah, I have no idea, dude. Too obscure. Winter Wyvern. So far, this pick is definitely proven well for Secret. We were wondering what support they would grab, and I think this was just the perfect choice. 1-0-5, Pylai Dai having a fairly flawless game thus far. We'll see Empire smoke up, move into the Roche pit. They've hit the sticky icky. Will it be a fake back or will it be a Roche? They're going to commit the Metamorphosis for this. Looking at Secret Vision, they've got no clue. At least not yet. They see somebody on the minimap here. Looks like this Roche will just go down uncontested. It's a pretty slow Roche. But it doesn't matter.
It's still going to benefit them. Then it's just like right under their noses. So that's really good for them. They have the BKB also completed on the Razor. As we were talking about, this Scandal is going to be a monster in these team fights. So they're going to have a very hard time of locking him down. The only thing that really goes through the BKB is going to be that Axe Call, maybe the Winter Wyvern Curse if you want to have a setup or like trying to run away.
Right.
But you have to remember that change, though. If you don't Winter Wyvern curse the BKB target, he's just going to walk right past you.
Yeah, and often not really the target you want to focus on. Sometimes it's the right play, but often you want to save it for somebody else who might be
like
a little
Terror
more
Blade.
Vulnerable. Yeah.
Maybe if Terrorblade and Razor are next to each other, but in most cases they won't be.
Yeah, they shouldn't be at least
they
on paper
be.
If they're playing this properly. Both teams have a fresh BKB now. Razor as well as Slark. 10 seconds of magic immunity. That was the next item here for our Teezy.
Yep.
Tome of Knowledge being ferried out as well on the courier for Puppy, it looks like.
Yep.
Or maybe Pylai Die.
It's just... It's one of those games where, like, Slark is... You don't want to get that BKB, but just like, ah, damn it, I actually have to if I really want a team fight all the time. For that 10-second duration, you're just like, I need it. I need it. And then if he can steal a lot of stats, kite him in the team fights, I can see him doing a lot onto the Terrorblade.
Yeah, no doubt, man. Scandal now getting some armor pieces up. He's got a plate mail. I would imagine that's going to be an Assault Kuros. Natural synergy with the Razor. He's having minus armor with that physical ult that also does additional minus armor. What do you think about the Aghanims on Razor?
I actually like Shiva's more
okay.
in this game.
All right, go
because,
on.
Because
all the melee?
Yeah, melee and vision as well as the wall. Like, you want to kind of clear the wall illusions too.
Okay, yeah, I like that part.
So, I do think he will go back for AC, and AC is still a great choice nonetheless if he wants to get that.
Yeah, they're both good. But you're right, Shiva's might be slightly added incentive this game. Force Staff on Eternal Envy, getting a little bit of utility on his Dragon Knight. All right, so it's going to be a Hurricane Pike, I guess. Interesting. Not an item I've ever seen on DK, I don't think. The Dragon Lance is pretty common, but
yeah, this is
upgrading it a little different.
It's not very good, all things considered, right? He should go for a BKB himself instead, but...
I'm not sure if it's good or bad. I've just never seen it.
Like,
it's different, that's for sure.
I just think BKB is way better. In this situation, I'm not saying you can't go back for it later, but at this stage in the game, when you have Arteezy already building a BKB, like, I think you should have it on your other core too, but, and it's not like a TA, right? You're not having a Desolator, you don't have the crit yet, you're just like, my damage is,
Yeah, I mean, he has been playing this kind of frontliner, like, hey guys, initiate on me, I'm Eternal Envy, I'm right here, and then his team kind of follows up, so if they continue to play that style, the Hurricane Pike makes some sense. It gives them a very easy way to disengage. It's not even a skill shot, you just pop it on somebody, you're instantly popped back, and you can reset the fight a little bit, so
I can see this the sense where he wants to disengage, but you don't really want to disengage when you already have Force Staff over on your axe, you already have Cold Embrace, and you have Mech. So you have so many defensive purposes
right.
with other heroes that this Hurricane Pike is not good.
I mean, honestly, I agree with you. I think the BKB is much more conventional.
Yeah,
I'm trying to like, I'm trying to reason this thing. I'm trying to find
trying
a reason.
No, I understand. I'm trying to reason.
Yeah.
Trying to get in his head too, and it can be good for getting away, but you're... Like you said, you hit the nail on the head. You're like, okay, I want the enemy team to focus me. And the way that you want them focused... Oh, top.
Yeah, here we go. They're going to go charging on in. King Ari can be the target of choice. Takes the Dragon Tail. Follow-up damage is there. He'll fall. Puppy, Berserker's Call into Ramses. Now the BKB gets used by Arteezy. He does have a Sunder available. Will he be able to get it off? It's going to turn the tide of this fight. It goes off onto Envy. All of a sudden, the Dragonite's quite low. But now Cold Embrace on Envy as well as the Winner's Curse on Ramses. Secret with all five still alive. They're in retreat mode now. Magnetized, forcing them back. Scandal pops his BKB as well. After all that, it's just a death on the support Vengeful Spirit, and it was a 4v5. Secret did not have their Darkseer for a lot of that. Bulba was sort of off to the side. No, I guess he did pop his Guardian Greaves. Okay, he just moved off to the side with the rest of the team. Meanwhile, Envy may be left behind. Puppy and Arteezy, though, they catch him on the backside. Lepulsion gets dunked after Afterlife gets brought down. Scandal tries to TP out, and he will make it. And after all that, it is a 3-0 in favor of Secret. Puppy getting a brilliant counter initiation there at the end.
Yeah. This Eternal Envy Force Staff doing some work actually in these team fights there. It actually did. That was a really good pickup, all things considered, because Afterlife pretty much messed up really bad there. Like, he just whiffed it. He messed up his ultimate. He didn't find a good initiation really. So, and not without having the Earthshaker Echo Slam. That's a big key component to these team fights. But still, Aegis just expired.
Yep. Uh-oh. Puppy finds King R, the Vengeful Spirit again. Target that gets initiated on. Envy goes scooting on in. There's the stun, and King R will fall to the power of the axe. back-to-back deaths on him. Secret continuing this trend of non-stop aggression. Like, this area of the map, they have spent so much time in this game. It's been so hard for Empire to safely farm in their jungle.
Yeah, and then trying to get more map control there is why King R dies there. He's just like, oh, well, let me go put up some wards, let me D-ward, and I just died. So, probably not the best when you have Metamorphosis down, and you can't just push out together.
Oh, Pylai die with the Jukes. Juke again. Well, clears out the tree line. That was TP home. What a player.
Yeah, Mpushka probably should have kept it. They should also use Reflection a little sooner, too, to get that vision.
Maybe thinking it could be bait of some sort. A lot of the secret players were off the map. Pretty aggressive warding down here. Look at the area in the mid lane, as well as the plateau up top. Uh-oh, down bottom, they find Ramzes. Puppy catches him with a Berserker's Call. There is a Sunder. He'll get it off onto Bulba, but now the wall, back. He's down to about half HP. Envy trying to get in for a Dragon Tail, but a Fissure blocks him out. And they will keep Ramzes alive. A little bit of a close call, but he's all good for now. He does have a Scotty completed, by the way. I don't think we mentioned that, but Terrorblade.
Yeah, he just got it.
Getting pretty big.
About, like, 2 minutes ago.
Okay.
Yeah, it's...
It's a big pickup.
Very scary, especially when he gets that Butterfly, though.
Yeah.
And he is just skyrocketing in the net worth. So Arteezy is probably going to have to itemize to that.
What's he got on the courier here? I think he spent his gold on something. Scotty. It's Scotty. Yeah. All right. So he's Scotty MKB.
Yeah, Scotty MKB. You either go for MKB into Abyssal or the MKB Scotty.
All right. Axe with Ghost Scepter now. Puppy getting some more survivability. The way he plays this Axe, I think that's a pretty smart item choice. I like it.
I really like Puppy's playstyle.
Yeah.
I think Universe kind of like... I don't know if he pioneered the Blink and Force Staff. It just kind of reminds me of like Clockwork plays. Maybe not. You don't necessarily need that Blink, but you just get that hook, which is in this case, you know, the call. Then you just Force Staff away, reposition, and just do it again.
Yeah, it's just the insane mobility. You can jump in, start it off, and then find a way to exit the fight without just conceding your life. Even Pylai die. He's moving into a Force Staff next. And he's pretty close. Just working on that recipe money right now. So even more mobility for Team Secret. That is definitely the name of the game. Right now they've got one Force Staff, another one on the way, a Hurricane Pike, and two Blink Daggers, plus Slark with a Shadow Blade. He's already pretty darn mobile.
The reason why this game looks so good for Secret right now is just because of all the things you just mentioned. Like, the mobility factor for Secret to just disengage, re-engage is the biggest thing. Whereas Empire, they don't have lockdown.
Yeah.
That they are just desperate for some... Oh, mid there.
Oh, here we go. Dunk onto Puppy. There will be some follow-up. It is the Shiva's guard on Razor, as you mentioned. It'll help secure that kill.
I like how I said they don't have lockdown right as they get that dunk, though. But you know what I mean.
Limited lockdown, for sure. Yeah. That's a big cooldown they had to use there to get that kill on Puppy. And ultimately, that's a 5-hero smoke and an Echo Slam for just an Axe.
I'm very surprised they committed it.
Yeah.
They could have had the... Normally what you want to do is you want to Fissure Stun first, Blink in, and then use your Enchant Totem.
Alright, Empire. Oh, what are they going to find? Envy stunned up. He's got some friends inbound, but I don't think they'll be able to save him. They'll even use the Magnetize here, and that's another pick off for Empire. Clawing their way back into this game.
Could have had that BKB TP. No, just kidding.
Defusal on Ramzes now.
That's very interesting. That is helping out a lot for the damage, but at the same time, it's no Butterfly. I think it's a really good item, though, for chasing.
Mm-hmm.
I actually think this is an undervalued item on Terrorblade.
Dude, we've seen so much Terrorblade, and I don't think I've seen a single Defusal game yet, and all the coverage we've seen on the panel and everything else.
I think it's very good here. Honestly, you want to have more stats, because I don't think 2,000 life is the best for a Terrorblade. Right now, considering he doesn't have evasion, but the amount of DPS he's going to output is absurd.
Synergizes so well with Illusion Heroes, just in general. Alright, we'll see. What's the game plan for Secret now? After those pickoffs, they've just been pretty happy splitting the map, maybe waiting for next Roche. It's a pretty long respawn, but we'll be up here in just a couple seconds.
Yeah, that's why Empire were like, okay, well, we know the Roche timer. It could spawn soon. That's why we went for that Echo Slam play on the mid lane.
Mm-hmm.
But it didn't spawn, and then they got that kill on Envy, and it's like, oh, well, Roche still hasn't spawned, so...
That's just unlucky, honestly.
Yeah.
This is such a long Roche respawn.
Yep.
RNG in favor of Secret.
Yep, because Empire should have had it all things considered, the way they played the last 2 minutes of this game.
Yeah, and Aegis would be pretty big for them in terms of trying to hold the high ground. Earthshaker moving into his second big item after the blink. That'll be the Yule's Scepter. Okay, no Force Staff for him, but getting a reset tool and an ability to catch.
I think Yule's is the best item against Axe. Like, you can Yule's him, and nobody's going to be attacking him. So it's like, okay, well, what do you do? You can also just
Great counter engage.
Yeah, it's really good for the counter engage against Axes.
I like it.
But you also have the fissures and stuff. It's also just a reset. It's either the Yule's or the Force Staff.
Yep. So Roshan, he's up. Now smoke from Secret. They're going to come up from the low ground, try and catch Empire from behind. Arteezy lingering in the mid lane. There is a Dire Observer, or pardon me, Sentry Ward down. Axe goes cruising on in. They grab Maposhka straight away. Arteezy goes flying in on the backside. It's a very scattered fight. Secret starting it off pretty well. Afterlife drops the dunk, but it doesn't save the Earth Spirit. Eternal Envy taking a lot of damage. The snowballs from Ramsey's starting to add up, but he gets surged. He'll be okay. Arteezy with the BKB on. He jumps in. It's a bold initiation. It's going to cost him his life. It's a one for one.
Arteezy?
That was a really awkward play from Arteezy, and a swap onto Pylai Dai makes it a one for two. Empire, they're going to beeline it straight to the Roche Pit, as they well should.
Like, Arteezy wasted his ulti earlier on, and that's basically what killed him as he went back in. I don't blame him for going back in when his team is there, but him going in when he doesn't have his ulti up is...
Yeah.
That's devastating.
I mean, the way the fight started, too, most of Secret came in, like, up this way, and they started the fight over here. That's
yeah,
what Puppy got the call.
Was over
Arteezy
there.
Went
yeah.
all the way in this way.
Exactly.
It was a 4 plus 1, and it did not bode well for Secret. I mean, Arteezy's pretty farm, but he's not at that level where he can just go in by himself and just clean up all these solo kills without support.
Yeah, just... It looked like a little bit of an inexperienced play on a Slark there when you pop your ulti so early on like that, especially when the Earthshaker is like on the other side of the map.
Yeah. Wow. Empire with a big sign of life there. Of course, they win the fight, but they get the big prize. The Aegis of the Immortal goes into the hands of the Terror Blade for Ramsey. He's also up to 4,000 gold. One of the issues with the Diffusal, though, is it's a relatively low-ticket item that does take up a slot. Like, how do you start to transition now? Like, what's the next item for Terrorblade? Do you look for just a BKB? Is that pretty safe and sound?
It's either Butterfly or Radiant's Satanic.
Yeah, the Butterfly, I think, is probably better. It's just not a good BKB game.
It's,
Secret have too many things to go
decent,
through it.
It's a decent BKB game, but yeah, it's like, it's definitely...
It's not
the best
ideal
because there's
yeah.
just so many things that can go through, and you want to have another damage item in this game because actually you do have the Razor to fall back on. I feel like this is more like a utility Razor right now. He doesn't necessarily have all that heavy hitting. It seems like the Razor is playing like the DK this game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely. And you know, speaking of Shiva's, Puppy's completed his now, so hooking another big core item on the Axe. And what is Envy working on? It's got to be something. He's got 4k gold himself. Last item we saw him pick up was the Hurricane Pike.
Needs a BKB still, but he's so far behind that he needed to have that AC completed. So it's either AC or BKB.
Yeah, Bulba also getting his BKB now on the Darkseer as he's finished up his Blink as well as his Greaves. Still a pretty even game. There's the BKB on the Dragon Knight. So two fresh BKBs for Secret in this next engagement as well as the surprise Shivas. They are still in control of this game. Empire definitely could still make this happen.
Yeah, one good Echo Slam on one or two key heroes, and they'll kill that hero, and then all of a sudden, if that hero doesn't have buyback, like Envy, because he just bought the BKB, like it could just be game over.
Mm-hmm.
So they have to be very careful now.
Wow, look how fast this tower dies. Secret gonna hang on to the glyph, save it in case of a high ground siege. Plenty of time left on the Metamorphosis. Also a double damage on the Terrorblade. Okay, that's why it fell so quickly. It's hard to see with all of his particles and all these illusions.
Can you count that damage, though? Can you count that Ooh. Damage?
Oh my god, dude. This is disgusting. A perfect time for a double damage rune. Still plenty of time left on the Aegis. He's also got 6,000 gold. Ramsey's getting low. He does have a Sunder. Is he going to be able to use it? Look how fast Arteezy dies. He's pushed back already. Now the Tier 3 tower goes down. They've already glyphed. Ramsey's will just go ahead and use it on Maposhka to get healed up. Scandal trying to do what he can from the low ground. This is a free lane of barracks for Empire.
What just happened? They just got punched in the face. Are they what?
Literally like game-winning double damage rune right there. Incredible.
Well, now they have to go for Secret.
I mean, the game's not over yet, but that is a huge burst of momentum for Empire. Look at that gold graph. It's going to update even more, and I think this game's a break even at this point. All about execution. Yes.
Man, just think of the implications of this game. Like, Secret potentially tying for that first place slot and not going to have it, and then Empire just...
Yeah, after
having their life, like you said, they started what, 1-3?
They were 1-4 at the end of day one. That was when I woke up today and looked at the stats for my notes. Like, wow, Empire got worked day one. And today they have been on kind of a tirade. This is do or die. I mean, Secret will still have a chance at tiebreakers to make it into the bracket. If they lose this, they're secured in that sense. Empire, they need this win to have a chance to make it to the next level.
And you're just
loss here is guaranteed elimination.
The more desperate team is just like, just playing better right now. They're executing, you know, better, but still it's Secret's game not to lose, but it's still very even. Like, I would say maybe now it's like 60-40 Empire, but it's still so close because, like we talked about, as long as Secret kite in these team fights, it's still hard for Empire to win them.
All right, Scandal got himself an Eye of Scotty. It's turned into a Scotty game here. Three Scotties. A lot of farm coming out.
Ain't nobody going nowhere.
Yeah, absolutely.
Unless you got a four staff.
Man, Earthshaker just picked one up. Even more mobility. Stopped off for the Yules first, but right back into the four staff. Pretty standard for Mr. Earthshaker there. I think we'll see Secret take a slightly more passive turn, though, after those missteps. They're going to wait for Empire to kind of come to them. Long time till the next Roche comes up. So maybe this will just turn into a little bit more of a farm fest until another objective. Next Roche will be Roche 3, of course, Aegis Cheese. Yeah. Prize ripe for the taking.
I don't think you can give it the Terrorblade anymore. And you have Razor. Razor, he would love to have an Axe so he could actually siege the high ground with his ultimate.
Is it actually worth it at this point, though? Like, he's starting to run a little low on slots.
But I'm just saying, like,
you want it.
since you want the Razor to siege the high ground now when he gets the Aegis, because the Terrorblade shouldn't have it unless he drops, like, his Boots of Travel or something.
Yeah. Eye of the Storm no longer persists through death, though, with the Aegis. They got rid of that little indirect buff to Razor a while ago. Really not a great Aegis carrier in general. But you're right, Terrorblade limited on slots. He has picked up the Butterfly now, though, and does have enough gold for buyback. Ramsey's in a really good position as Empire smoke up, move through their own jungle. They are on the hunt.
Where do we go? Let's look for some Secret. Envy.
Are they going to find a catch here? Envy opens with a dunk. Oh my, this Dragon Knight in a world of hurt. Secret nowhere nearby. They can't save their DK. He does have a buyback. But Empire in a really great position all of a sudden. They're feeling confident. This is without an Aegis, without anything. They're just going to go right towards the high ground and try and force this buyback. No glyph available for Secret, so they are going to have to make a decision fast here. Look how fast the tower dies, Alan. My god. How do you stop this?
You don't.
Terrorblade is just insane. Puppy goes in, he gets silenced straight away. Now Artesia initiates under Ramsey's back wall. Ramsey's getting low, but he's got the Sunder. Can he get it off? It's a beautiful winner's curse onto Scandal. It's not going to be enough to secure the kill, but Bulba, he's the victim of the Sunder. Now he's going to be relegated back towards the well. Artesia gets stunned up, force staff back. He'll survive, but the Barracks not going to be so lucky. Melee have already fallen. Who cares about the range? King R caught by the Berserker's call as the rest of the fight breaks out up top. Envy outside of the base trying to finish off Ramsey's. Scandal getting low and well as well. Ramsey's on the run. 20 seconds till Sunder comes back up. He gets back. Scandal gets dunked. Ramsey's on the run. I don't think he's going to be able to live through this one. Only 100 HP as Envy gets some sweet, sweet vengeance with his Hurricane Pike Breathe Fire combo. There was a buyback used to make that hold, quote unquote. It was on Eternal Envy. It's a 4,000 net worth swing here. It didn't count the buyback for some reason. But I said hold in air quotes because they still lost the melee barracks. Even though Empire got wiped up, ultimately they got what they came for.
They need to go down mid so fast right now. The problem is they don't even have the Elder Dragon to seize their high ground now. So it's like, well, we can push mid, but we don't push that fast. And the question is, who are they going to wait? They have buyback on Razor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so they're just going to waste the buyback on Razor. And that's a good call. And they shouldn't fight too much. No, they shouldn't fight at all.
Glyph, too. This is a tough call for Secret. I'm not sure if they can actually do
this.
No,
you can't. With that buyback, you can't.
Yeah. Secret are in a lot of trouble here. Roche is up in 2 minutes. It is another very long respawn. Empire, I think, can afford to be kind of patient here and then look to secure the Roche and get that Aegis cheese. MKB up on the Slark, so can now deal with the Butterfly. It's a big increase for Arteezy.
Yep.
But he no longer has buyback, 1600 gold short.
It's definitely a play they need to make. If they're not able to focus the Terrorblade down, then they're not going to win. You just saw in the last team fight, they kind of set everything kind of perfectly, but not perfectly at the same time. It's kind of weird to say because they don't have lockdowns after the axe calls, right? Besides like the Winter Wyvern Curse, the only way they're going to catch the Terrorblade is if Eternal Envy goes on him.
Uh-oh, Arteezy, he's going to break the smoke. Maposhka blinks back, Echo Slam to get it started, but Arteezy able to jump away. Envy goes cruising on in. Everyone's still pretty healthy. BKB popped by Scandal as well as Arteezy. There's the Winter's Curse. It's on to Scandal. It's a little bit lackluster. Puppy gets brought down by Ramzes. He's still hanging on to that Sunder. Back wall from Bulba just tickles. Ramzes going to kill his own illusion here as now Scandal gets stunned up. The Shadow Dance from Arteezy keeping him safe under the guise of invisibility.
Oh,
kill
that
the Vengeful
Thunder.
Spirit. Oh, Ramzes, he's going to be able to bring him down. Darksteer falls. There are some buybacks still available for Secret, but this is Empire's fight. They've only lost their support Venge as they start to disengage.
Bulba dies back. Buys back, yeah. Dies back yet? No.
He did not die back yet. So not a game-ending play here for Empire. Kind of a sloppy fight, but two buybacks used for Secret. I think Empire will still be pretty happy with that. Now Secret will have to be very cautious around this fight at the Roche pit, because if they die there without buybacks, this game could end pretty quick. We are starting to see the power of the Darks here at this stage of the game, though. Those Terrorblade illusions put up one hell of a fight.
Yeah, it's like, well, guys, this Terrorblade's actually killing me. That's what Ramzes is saying. Like, help! But these They have to stop it. I don't know how they are. They just need to stop these Sunder spinning. And the best way is to have like a sheep stick. And they don't have it yet on anyone. Envy's
Afterlife, he's going to get caught here. He's got a lot of mobility tools, but that's just going to be a freebie. Of course, he has a buyback. Not the end of the world. Still a nice pick, though, for Secret. Are they building a scythe?
They're going to go...
doesn't look
not
like
yet.
It.
I mean, normally Bulba will get one probably next. And Shiva's is still good for Dark
that
Spirit
buyback,
too.
Though. It's cost him a lot of money. Secret, yeah. They're going to go high risk. They're going to move right into the Roche pit. Dire, they've got a ward right here on the high ground. They know what's going on. They can see Bulba. They're going to go right for it. This is a slow Roche from Secret as well. Earth Shaker might be dead, but Empire can still do this if they want to. There's the buyback. TP in outside of the base with the buyback. Secret think twice.
It's so
and they
game
leave the pit.
Losing because Envy already committed for the Dragon Knight. He's like, guys, we have to do this. Guys.
Oh yeah, use the ult.
Like they have to commit for this. No, if they don't, they're just gonna lose.
This is do or die. So many buybacks on cooldown. Only the Earth Spirit as well as the Terror Blade able to buy back into the game. Most of them on cooldown. Everyone else short on gold. Yep. Roche still reasonably healthy here.
Empire
team
is playing this so well right now. They're patiently waiting on DK ulti. This is good play from a 5-4 soon to be team potentially.
Yeah, they know exactly what's going on here. Elder Dragon form close to expiration now. Only
about a quarter left. Arteezy found him, but he's got the ulti. Where's that high ground? No.
Oh, Afterlife, that's a dieback on him. That's actually huge. Secret have a window here. BKB's being popped on both sides of the coin. Arteezy's is on cooldown. Envy's still active, but now expires. Scandal used his as well. Secret on the back foot. They'll start to retreat.
Oh, Terrorblade. Hey, boy. Hey, boys.
Oh, God, he's in the base. He's going for the rat play. Here we go.
Thanks for the courier.
Glyph has been used. It's a free courier kill. Puppy comes back. What's in the play here, Ramzes? He does have a buyback available. Don't forget, he's doing a lot of damage to these towers. He just kills buildings so fast. Secret having trouble dealing with this. He does have a Sunder available. Berserker's Call comes out. Can he get the Sunder off? No, the slam dunk is there. And Pylai dies, secures the kill. It was a noble effort from the Terrorblade, but he gets punished for his insolence. One tier 4 tower still standing. Secret hanging on by a thread, but they're still in this game.
Yeah, if they didn't have this tier 2 tower up, that would have probably been Megas. So, thanking their lucky stars, they have this tower still. And they're going to get Roche potentially here. Not the biggest deal for Empire, but Arteezy coming in at the clutch, killing off that Earthshaker, giving Secret at least a chance in this game.
Roche getting low. Secret trying to commit to this. Terrorblade does not want to use his buyback for this. Empire looks like they're just going to let it go. And Secret will be rewarded with Aegis Cheese. Look at this graph, man. Secret was so far ahead, and now things are dead even. Net worth doesn't matter so much here 50 minutes into the game, but just paints the story so clearly of how topsy-turvy this match has been. Secret, well, they've got a win condition, but it's going to be tough. Aegis of the Immortal comes out on the Puppy's Axe, and the cheese is in the hands of Eternal Envy, at least for now.
You don't want to give the Aegis over to Dragonite. Doesn't have the same capabilities as the Terror Blade. You don't come back with a dragon, sadly.
Yeah.
Dragons, all dragons must die.
Yeah. For those that aren't sure what that reference is, Terror Blade does maintain the Metamorphosis buff through death. So if you die with meta on, then you buy back, you come back into the fight with the same duration left on the meta form, which is actually a really big buff when you get to this stage of the game. It's not like a Death Prophet where you can just kill her after the ult and know that she's out of the game for the next 2 minutes.
Yeah, thanks, Purge.
Hey, man. Not everybody knows those mechanics.
I'm all for that, explaining. I mean, I'm supposed to be explaining these things, but, you know, they're so trivial since I'm 2K MMR.
No. Idiot. Oh. Ramses with Diffusal Blade, level 2 now. Still hanging on to this Dragon Lance. I imagine that'll be the next item that gets swapped out. He's got another 6K gold, so he's looking close to picking up something next. But
I think it's Satanic.
Okay, just get that reset.
Yep.
You get second reset.
Two resets plus lifesteal. And for those people out there that don't know, Diffusal Blade is not an artifact.
Whoa!
Wow.
Mind-blowing.
If people
changes are confusing, though, to be fair. For a casual viewer, the whole mechanics of orb effects and Dota and what is, what was, what's been changed, it's ridiculously hard to follow.
It's okay, though. Can you have Eye of Scotty too, though? That's the question.
Uh-oh. Baking my noodle, man.
Yeah.
What's the play here for Secret? Like, they have this Aegis. Do they try to force the issue with it, or do they wait for Empire to kind of come to them? They've got about half duration left, 3 minutes here until it expires. Like, how big of a deal is the Aegis for Secret? Is it?
It's more so denying it so that Empire can't end the game, and it's trying to give Secret at least some like leeway, get so they can just farm up maybe some more core items and just fill out the map, pressure back Empire. Farm those buybacks for Secret and try to wait them out as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I see. Makes sense, though. If Empire get that Roche, they can basically just run up the mid and kind of win the game. If Secret get it, it at least stalls things out. It doesn't really give them a clear win condition, but it allows them to stay in the game, keep farming, and have another shot.
They can't go high ground yet. They need another Roche or Aegis, realistically. They need another... Like, the problem with this game is that Eternal Envy is so poor that... It's hurting the team because he's not that farmed. His items are more defensive by nature, and he's just not dealing enough damage to this Terror Blade.
I mean, for 53 minutes, this is a fairly lackluster Dragonite. Still hanging on to the Armlet, Hurricane Pike, as we've talked about, atypical. Understand the reasoning for it here, but not an item we're used to seeing on the DK. And BKB, very core, but not very damage intensive.
Yeah, an armlet's just like cheap.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, armlet is a throwaway item. I replace that for pretty much anything else. Although, to be fair, Arteezy still has his Echo Saber. Probably the next item he'll be looking to replace.
Yeah, that'll probably go into a butterfly.
Yeah, most likely. And then he could always upgrade this Shadow Blade into a Silver Edge for just a slot improvement, slightly more stats, better cooldown, all that good stuff.
Yeah, so we haven't reached, you know, six slotted territory. Probably in 10 minutes we will. Where everybody's got their six slots if it goes that long with moon shards and everything.
Buybacks are just about refreshed. The Earthshaker, the only one still on cooldown, and less than a minute. So we'll probably be available for this next big fight. And there is that Satanic on the Terror Blade, like you were talking about. So Ramsey's now even harder to kill. You've got a Sunder you got to deal with, and you've got the Unholy Rage that'll also heal him up really fast. That's the other thing. He's just so much damage now, just a couple of right clicks, and he's going to be right back at full health almost instantly.
It feels so good when every time, you know, Andrew just says, you're right, so much in a game. It's just like, man, I'm just... Yeah, it feels good.
You know, I try to be positive. You got to channel the positivity these days. You know, try not to flame too much. But what are you gonna do?
I like flames though.
Yeah, is Earth Spirit looking at a refresher? He's got a Perseverance and 3K gold. Poshka going for the double magnetized.
You should have said ES. You'd be that person.
Yeah.
Which ES Andrew, please.
I've already confused it enough this game. Between the Earth Shaker Spirit and the Earth Spirit Shaker.
The Earth Spirit. What was it called again? Timber Blade?
The Timber Blade.
You got
Stop
the
it.
Timber Blade.
Oh, my dyslexia, dude. It's messing with me. Oh, 55 minutes. These teams have so much on the line here. The stakes are worth reiterating at this stage. Do or die for Empire, and a win here for Secret puts them in a much better situation in terms of the tiebreaker scenarios that are looming. Envy has invested in another item. It is the Assault Kuros.
Yep.
Great team item here. Will definitely help things out.
And then he needs to get MKB, but he also just needs to farm buyback. Yeah, I think the good luck to the buyback more so at this stage.
Yeah. So the Aegis has expired. Puppy has an inventory slot now, and we will see that butterfly get completed for Arteezy. So
can I hear it again?
A few more big items coming out. Yeah, no, it was a good call, though. You're right. He went straight for the butterfly.
No.
That one a little easier to predict, I think. Not too many other options for the Slark.
No, Dagon 5? I think that's the thing.
Dude, I mean...
I mean, with Eternal Envy's build, you never know.
Yeah, Pylai Dai, what's he got here? Aether Lens, Force Staff, so pretty basic kit over there. He still only died once this game.
That is very good.
Arteezy's only died once, too, but for a support Winter Wyvern, and he's had some close calls. There were a couple slick jukes that we saw half an hour ago.
Empire more like building slayers this game.
Yeah.
They're just like Godzilla. We come, we smash.
Moving into stalemate territory here with buybacks coming up. Both teams just waiting for the opposition to make that misplay that they can capitalize on.
Empire just need to really get this tier 2 tower top. That should be their goal. I'm really surprised they don't want to.
Yeah, you know Secret's going to defend that, though, with everything they've got.
That is a good defense spot, but it's also very hard to defend because...
Couldn't Empire just go for the tower and then split push with the Terra Blade? I mean, he's got the BOTs.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That's what I was saying. Like, there's so many different things they can just do to just get this tier 2. And then you're like, okay, well, we can actually rat our way to victory in this top tower for the Megas.
Does Terrorblade really need 38 base armor? That is just insanity, dude. He's got no armor items, and he's at 40 plus. What a hero.
Fine.
5,500 gold up on Scandal. Everybody pulling a lot of gold at this point. So, do you think he goes Aghanim's here on the Razor? Do they have an AC on the Dire yet? They do not. He could still go for the Assault Kuros. Don't know how effective that would be at this stage.
Honestly, I love Refresher Ags here for Scandal, but that's me personally.
I mean, they almost don't need more pushing power, though. If they can get to the structures, Terrorblade takes them out fast.
But the thing is, it also gives, like, negative armor debuff onto the enemy heroes, too. Mm-hmm. So, and then you refresh your BKB, you refresh your Shiva's Guard. So, and you refresh your Static Link. Like, double Static Link in teamfight, that got him.
Yeah, I do agree that it feels like this is Scythe of Ice territory. For both teams, having like anyone who can blink Hex at this stage of the game can be game-changing. You know, you catch somebody without a BKB.
Yeah.
And a little bit surprised to see neither team going for anything Hex-related. Maposhka actually goes for the Lotus Orb, so not the refresher that I was posturing about.
Yeah, that's really good, though.
Yeah.
You can just return so many different things.
Yeah, and good for purging in case a Scythe of Ice does come out.
Yep.
Yeah. But Scandal, now he will go into the Assault Kuros, it looks like. Plate mail picked up for him, and now the MKB for Mr. Terrorblade. He is pretty capped at this point. Still can eat a Moon Shard, still can get those Tier 2 Boots of Travel, but I think his basic inventory here is about as good as it's going to get. I don't know what else you'd want to replace at this point.
He can go for that gem, though, for his team.
Buy a gem for his team? You know, there are always things that you can do beyond this. You know, you get the Refresher back at home. That's like the first 7th slot item that most heroes go for, but for Terrorblade, it's actually quite good. Because of just the nature of Metamorphosis, you can just buy back, refresh, and it's like, alright, got another meta. Yeah. So even though his core kit is kind of capped out here, there's still a lot of ways he can go.
Actually, I'm going to blow your brain right now.
Please.
You TP back to base, refresh, TP back in.
Cheese and crackers, Alan. What are you thinking? I don't want to play pubs against you. That just sounds dirty. I mean, they're almost at the point where Empire can just go right for the base. So, you know, he can do plays like that, and their ability to kill him is there, but it's tough, man. With only one tier 4, this is scary territory. Roche up in 30 seconds. Another long-ish Roche respawn. This is like another max timer. That's like 3 in a row. Very unlucky.
Man, Arteezy. The hero or the zero?
Uh-oh.
He's backing out.
It's brewing. We're going to take a look at Vision here. Dire completely blind. Radiant, they have the intel. They've got a ward on the high ground. They know exactly where Empire are. This could be a great opening for them to try to initiate. But no, it's Arteezy that gets initiated on. He pops the BKB straight away after the swap.
Afterlife.
Isolated by Eternal Envy. Huge plays over
Scandal.
There. South Scandal caught by the Winner's Curse. They're going to bring him down. Ramsey just killing his own teammates. Back wall from Bulba. Sets it up on two. This is Secret's fight to take. Buy back from the Ranger. Now the Echo Slam does big damage, but it's not enough to find kills. Envy put inside of the Cold Embrace. He'll survive for now. Ramsey's getting low. The Sunder's not going to be enough. Secret with all their heroes still alive except for Bulba. Now they're going to lose Arteezy. Empire had to use only one buyback
chop
for that to happen, but Puppy gets the chop onto the Earthshaker. It's a 5-for-2 overall. Empire, all in a lot of trouble. They were even the ones that started that fight with the swap on Arteezy.
He just knew it was coming. He was baiting it out. He had
that
the dark
was pure bait all the way.
Yeah, he was dark packing the whole time, and so he didn't get caught out. Because what Empire did, they pre-planned that. They had the kick immediately hit Arteezy, but he was ready for it. Else Arteezy would have died.
Up top, Eternal Envy going for the structures. There's the glyph from Empire. Scandal comes cruising in, the lone defender. He will push him back at least for now, but even forcing out the glyph is a minor victory for Secret at this stage. Scandal doing everything he can as Envy takes out that top tier 3 tower. Exposed barracks, now going to start getting chipped away at. Vengeful Spirit has respawned. Empire are going to stay in this game without burning any buyback. This is where things get really interesting here, Alan.
I don't know if any other team would have not buyed back just one hero. I mean, Empire, you're just making me Craigasm right now because...
Talk about confidence.
They understood that Dragonite ulti is going down soon, and they have no spark. They have no damage whatsoever to take these buildings. I mean, that if that doesn't show a top-tier team, I don't know what the hell to... That... Ace deny, though.
Get out of here, Ace Rune. We don't have time for any of that. Now the upgraded BOTs come out on Terrorblade. This is where the rap plays get really scary. You can now jump onto heroes. They'll go right into the Roche pit. And I don't think Secret can contest this one. They're not going to be able to get here in time. Slark's still dead for 3 seconds. They are going to start to move towards the pit. Roche actually falling slower than I thought it would. Are Secret going to be able to contest? BKB gets popped by Bulba. He pulls two up to the high ground. Ramsey's caught by the wall.
Afterlife dead.
Oh, Slark gets him on the backside. We're still looking at Roche. He's still standing. Empire completely committed to this. It will go down to the Dire. Terrorblade, the one to pick up the Aegis, but it could cost Ramsey's everything. Still hanging on to that Sunder. Oh, Secret. This is bold. Maybe too bold. Envy caught by the Cold Embrace. He'll survive for now. Empire with all five alive after the buyback on the Earthshaker. They'll get the kill on
S, though.
This Magnetize doing so much work. Envy trying to split one way. Pylai dying, Bulba going the other. They are going to go on to Envy. He turns, brings down the Vengeful Spirit before he falls. That
Wait.
We call it a throwaway item, but he's toggling.
Oh my god.
Secret on the back foot now. Trying to retreat. There's the dunk from Afterlife. Doesn't do a hell of a lot. A buyback's already been used by the puppy. This guy right here. There it is. He pops the Ghost Scepter. He needs to live here. I can't believe Eternal Envy survived through all that. Armlet toggling, dude. That was some sick, nasty armlet toggling.
Took away. Afterlife bought back.
Oh my god. Arteezy, he's getting low. He's getting force stabbed all around. He's completely isolated outside of the base. He gets clipped by the Fissure. Empire trying to isolate, but Bulba, he's nearby with another great back. Now Puppy reinitiates. They go in onto Ramsey's. Remember, he's still got the Aegis of the Immortal. Even if they kill him once, he's coming right back. Puppy using this Ghost Scepter so well. Scandal in too deep. He falls to the Darkseer. Ramsey's now taking right clicks to the back from the Slark. That's the Aegis of the Immortal. It'll be down. Maposhka low on HP, trying to retreat. Puppy somehow still alive. Oh my god. God, Ramsey's now. Can he do this? It's been one long, drawn-out fight. They're going to try to catch Afterlife. Puppy, is he having the Berserker's call? No, he's going to TP out instead. Looks like this fight will finally start to settle down. And we're going to talk about who actually won that ridiculous exchange.
I don't know. That's just Dota.
That was insane. So let's talk about buybacks, though.
Dota, guys. Yeah.
Afterlife
first
had
buybacks.
To use one at the Roche pit. And then Axe had to use another in that fight. Roche died, Aegis went to the Dire. That was just insane. There were so many huge individual plays. The fact that we don't have instant replay for that is actually a crime.
Yeah, I'm just going to say the biggest highlight of that is just Maposhka, like 3-2-2-ing. I can clearly say that was... I don't know if he meant to put a stone down and he misclicked or something, but he just kicked Eternal Envy away to freedom. Like, that was like... Oh, man, that was... That feels so bad if you're Maposhka in there in that situation, but they were able to bring down the Terrorblade twice, like even thrice. He popped his Satanic, And there was a Ghost Scepter up on on X, as well as, you know, the Shadow Dance from Slark. So I was like, oh my goodness, Satanic countered.
Here we go, top lane of Barracks getting cleaned up. No Glyph available for Empire. They've already lost the range, soon to be melee. Secret already starting to rotate around towards the mid lane. Now it's one set of Barracks apiece. Arteezy in the front lines, BKB at the ready. Envy in Elder Dragon form at about half duration. They'll be able to siege this tier 3 tower. Ramzes does have a buyback here. And Empire will be able to hold on. Secret not going to press their luck. Happy to just level the game out with one lane of Barracks and another tier 3 tower.
Yeah, and all things considered, his boots of travel got denied in the Roche pit, so he had to buy new ones.
A little unfortunate. He's got the money for it, though, I suppose.
Yeah.
He doesn't have his upgraded boots anymore. That's a pretty expensive item to be lost. At least he picked up the... I mean, what else are you going to drop there? Not your Manta, that's for sure.
Yeah, he really wishes he had that refresher now, though. That is a very key item for this Terrorblade. And
I think it's almost more important than the Moon Shard at this point, honestly.
Right.
Forget about the Moon Shard.
I don't think Moon Shard is the play here for Terrorblade, honestly.
I mean, it's one of those items that if you have enough gold, it can't hurt, but there's still quite a few other things. I mean, refresher, upgraded boots now, that's going to be plenty of money for the kind of foreseeable future here. So also, Scandal finally completes his Assault Cross, so that's nice.
He's like, oh, well, save for buyback. Might as well get it now, though. But the problem is he has all these defensive items. They just can't really do anything to really lock down the enemy heroes with it. So this game is still on the backs of, like, Arteezy. He just keeps on finding Afterlife in the back lines. They need to have the gem on him. Like, it's just absurd. With, oh, actually, Arteezy doesn't have the Shadow Blade anymore.
So, he picked up a Moon Shard now. He's just hanging on to it. Is it on the courier, or did he actually just get rid of it? Yeah, he ditched it.
I wonder if he dropped it at Roche too, guys. Who had that cheese, though? I didn't get to see who had the cheese.
Yeah, I'm not sure. It was way too chaotic. Yeah. There is a Heart of Tarrasque on the way for Eternal Envy, though. It's actually a pretty big item for this Dragon Knight.
Yep, it's pretty big.
4k HP, that's pretty good.
He's pretty much as tanky as the Razor right now. Like, they both have the same amount of armor. They almost, like, 1k HP difference. So, yeah. both heroes are kind of mimicking each other right now.
Yeah, we're getting some pretty seriously capped out heroes. Razor's still hanging on to his Dragon Lance. Next thing, he'll want to start to replace other BOTs. Secret have 5 BOTs.
It's like how they have all in the same slots.
Yeah, Empire not quite as high on the BOT train. It's just Ramzes for now. Still a whole bunch of Tranquil Boots over there. Both teams now with one Lotus Orb. We talked about the one Maposhka picked up, but Puppy, that was his most recent item investment here, that Lotus Orb.
All right. Got to calm down.
Got to recollect. Recollect here.
Yeah.
Simmer. Get that adrenaline back up.
Woosa.
This is going to be Roche number 5, I think, coming up. It's been a lot of Roches this game. I've lost track.
Should be 5.
Yeah. I think there's been 2 cheeses, so... Alright, we're gonna go back to this kind of static farm fest for now. You know, 15 minutes ago, I was saying, well, both teams playing a little passive, waiting for them to make a misstep. Now that's even more amplified. Both teams with one lane of Barracks down. Look at the gold graph as well. It just tells this crazy story of Secret's journey throughout this match. And now it all comes down to execution. Slark moving into Abyssal Blade, it looks like next. He'll eat the Moon Shard, picks up a Basher, Vanguard on the horizon.
And it's just showing why Secret's lineup is just scaling so well into this later stage in the game, where you have all these kiting, like kite, and it's just killing Empire, killing them. They're trying to chase, but they just can't catch anybody.
Yeah. They need to lock people down for that Terrorblade to get in the right clicks. Way easier said than done. Smoke rotation, Puppy, Ion shelled up. He's gonna find something. Smoke gets broken. Berserkers call on one, connects on Scandal. Instant Force Staff away into his friends. There's the Ghost Scepter. Ramzes in the front line, Secret, trying to pull Empire into an awkward position. Arteezy goes in onto Maposhka. Maposhka will survive. And it looks like Secret will just disengage there.
That's pretty big. Metamorphosis down. Can still buy Refresher, though.
Yeah, he's got another 6,000 gold.
It's like that Enigma play. You're like, oh, well, I whiffed that black hole, but I just refreshed, and you didn't know about it.
Yeah, that's true. You can do it in the well, and that's a really good point, actually. The secret refresher, where it's hard for the other team to get. You know he's super farmed, but gauging when exactly he's going to be able to grab that refresher, that's a potentially game-winning maneuver there. If they think you don't have Metamorphosis, they go all in, and then all of a sudden, bada-boom, bada-bing, you're the big bad demon again. I like that. I mean, at this stage of the game, Alan, you got to start coming up with crafty plays like that. I mean, this has been one hell of a topsy-turvy match with both teams having opportunities where it looked like they might be able to squeeze a win. So this is, if there was ever a time to pull out those kind of little pocket strats or cheeky plays, I think this is it.
Yeah, we got Cloud9 Eternal Envy in here, guys. This is like...
I wonder who Shoyo is.
This is... There are some wonky plays to be had if they really want to do it, but...
Roche coming up in about a minute here, though, at this point. Roche really doesn't
seem
to matter.
Please, Ramsey. Please.
8,000 gold. There it is. And he has enough for buyback with a 900 surplus. This is big. Swap. Eternal Envy into the tier 4s. Uh-oh, this could be it. He pops the BKB, gets a Lotus Orb buff, and he will get pushed back to safety. Now the dunk comes out from Afterlife. Big damage on the Puffy, but Cold Embrace is there. Eternal Envy on the back foot. Still alive, but it's Bulba with the plays. 4-hero Vac Wall. Follow-up from Pylai Dai. The Winner's Curse will be enough to bring down the Earth Spirit, but he's got a buyback straight into the game.
Easy.
It's still a 5v5. Arteezy does pounce back to safety. Ramses gets off Asunder. He uses it on one of his allies, but it will pick him back up. Now Envy, low on HP, four stabs again. This mobility for Secret, working wonders. Empire just can't get their hands on these targets. Splinter Blast, slowing things down a little bit. Secret with a lot of low HP heroes. They may try to reinitiate this. Ramses does not. Oh, he does have a Satanic. That's the Flutter that's on cooldown. But they're just a little bit too low on HP. Secret not comfortable with this. They will back out, and Empire will live to fight another day.
Oh, this is still kind of bad for Empire. Now they don't have Refresher.
Where's the Refresher? He used it already?
Yeah.
Okay.
So 80 seconds without Metamorphosis.
Is that all Secret was waiting for? Right now, Puppy's in the bottom lane. He's got his BOTs up. They did also force a buyback, so Secret did find a small advantage there.
No Satanic for 20 seconds, too, for Ramses. Does have Sunder still to work with. Has Swap from King R.
It was a noble start, though, from Empire to swap Envy into that precarious situation. It's a good try. It's the kind of stuff they need to
it's
do.
It's like half a second from getting that ES stun, chain stun afterwards, too, which would have probably dealt at least another 1,000 damage during that window.
Ranged barracks, fall in the mid lane, just melee standing. Secret continuing to slow siege this, feeling fairly comfortable right now. They are giving time for this meta to come back up, though. About 35 seconds, still a pretty big window. Lotus Orb reflects a stun onto King R. Envy down to about half HP, but the four staff train is in full effect. He gets Guardian Greaved up, and Envy will be just fine. With Heart of Terrasse, he can do that all day. Give him another 10 seconds out of combat, and he'll be regen up, no problemo.
So unfair, can't even swap because you just swap yourself back.
Yeah.
That Lotus Orb.
Now, at this stage, the Lotus Orbs are actually really, really important. There's only one on Secret, but Puppy's been using it pretty much perfectly so far.
Oh boy.
Uh-oh, smoke from Empire. Here we go. Sticky Icky out of the base. This is a bold play. Take a look at Dire Vision. They don't have a lot. They're completely blind. They see Arteezy. They see Puppy. Who do they go for? It's Puppy. Echo Slam used right away, but Pylite Eyes there. Cold Embrace resets things that might cost Pi his life, and it will. Up on the high ground, Arteezy and Scandal are going at it, but Ramses isolated by himself. Winter Wyvern will buy back. It's a 5v5 on the field.
Bulba.
Secret starting to
swap.
He's trying to TP home. There's the swap. It won't happen. Through the BKB, they should be able to bring him down. They'll lose the Earth Spirit. It's a dieback there. But they do get the high prize kill on Bulba. Now Puppy, stunned up by the Fissure. They're going to continue to pursue that pesky Ghost Scepter again, buying him some time. Ramses now in the fray. They should be able to bring Puppy down this time. The right clicks are really adding up. In comes Pylai Dai. Oh, that Winner's Curse. Scandal feeling the pain of the Terror Blade. It's not going to be enough. It's a deny, actually. That's awkward.
I thought they fixed that.
Well, apparently not. Arteezy comes in, helps secure the kill. Now buyback to plenty. The Darkseer as well as the Axe have bought back into the game. Empire have used all the buybacks they have. Their two supports are going to be in the grave for about 50 seconds, and now Ramsey's isolated outside of the base. He's still got his metamorphosis on, but he's taking big damage. Can he get off of Thunder here? He's got it, and no, it gets Lotus Orb. Oh my god, that's so unfortunate. He's in big trouble now. Low HP, Berserker's Call. They're finally going to bring him down. He's got the buyback. He'll use it instantly. Secret with all five still alive. Should be able to bring down Afterlife also. He does not have a buyback. That's three in the grave permanently for at least the next 20, 30 seconds. Scandal and Ramsey's. This is going to be a hard defense to make.
Can he please put the refresher on the courier so I know how much time is left? Yes, it is up. Okay, oh,
here
thank
we go.
Goodness.
Maybe they can hold this. He's going to refresh. He's going to pick up his BOTs again. Mid lane of barracks will get cleaned up, but they don't even care at this point. It's all about the heroes. So many buybacks on cooldown. If somehow they manage to wipe Secret, there is a win condition here for Empire. Look at this creep wave down bottom. They are going to TP back to deal with it. Smart plays from Secret. Instead of going all in here, they're going to play cool, calm, and collected and make sure they don't get caught by any rat Dota.
Yeah, that was a really bad play. If everybody goes back and looks at it for the Earthshaker, he should have just let the Terrorblade die and just buy back, use Refresher.
Yeah, you're right.
So that's just hindsight play. You're just like, oh, I need to help my Terrorblade. These two eyes hanging out. They got two eyes on the Roche Pit. I'm not Roche Pit, the Ancients. Look at this.
You're right. Those look like eyes, actually. Arteezy on the high ground. Whoa, this is bold. He's all by himself, but he's got an Abyssal Blade. Scandal not quite ready for it. He will go into the Shadow Dance and try to make it away now. Arteezy lives. He forces out the Metamorphosis as well. Oh no, Ramsey's. He's just used the Refresher.
Oh boy. Oh boy.
This
might be game losing.
What a good play from Arteezy. He forced Empire to panic, knowing his limits. Big play right there.
This is looking it.
Ramsey's, you can tell, he's like, we have to do something, guys. This is my Metamorphosis, the last one for 100 seconds. Now Arteezy goes back in, gets a bash straight away. Ramsey's will be all right, at least for now. Secret kind of spread about, but they are ready to take this fight if Empire want to commit for it. Arteezy, the target of choice for now, but Envy pops the Elder Dragon form. Arteezy just trying to split it up. They're going to focus on King R. Puffy and Envy going on the back line. Ramsey's getting low. There's the
curse.
Panic with the curse on to Scandal. Another great back wall from Bulba. They bring down the Venge. The Razor. Ramsey stays alive for now. He still has the Sunder. He could still hold it, but it's looking grim. That's a dieback for him. A dieback for the Razor. And as soon as Afterlife falls, we should be expecting the GG. There it is. After 75 minutes, Secret take the win, 38-18. Oh my, Empire, make them work for it. What a match. Great stuff for Secret, though. They are guaranteed now up in the top four, safe and sound, safe from those bottom tiebreakers. Empire, hearts broken to come this far and not make it into the playoffs for the TI6 qualifiers.